Hey friends, we're gonna show you some lacing and shoe tying techniques to help create a more enjoyable running experience. So let's start with the runner's loop or heel lock. We'll go down and show you on my shoe here. This is how you traditionally have the shoe laced, normal lacing as it comes out of the box. You notice an extra eyelet right here on the shoe that often doesn't get used. But we can use this to reduce volume here in the back of the shoe and reduce slipping at the Achilles. So to do this, we're going to take the lace and thread it outside in to create a little loop, a little bunny ear here. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Now I have two loops, my bunny's ears, and I'll thread the lace through the opposite loop. So notice we didn't tighten those ears down. We want to leave space to thread the lace. Now I tighten, the ears go down, I've reduced the volume in the back of the shoe, and I just tie like normal from here. When we tie like normal, we traditionally go with the loop, the swoop, and the pull. But I'm gonna show you a little better way to tie so that your shoes won't come untied on your run. I'm in my runner's loop, cross my laces, I create my loop. Now, my swoop actually should go underneath and then I'll pull through from there. So to show you again, instead of going over top of the loop, I'm going underneath the loop and pulling through. Doing this will leave you much less likely to have your shoes come untied while you're running. Now, I'm gonna show an alternate lacing method that's particularly nice if you have a higher instep or a wider midfoot. This is straight lacing, or what you might call ladder lacing. I took the normal lace shoe, unlaced it, except for the very bottom. We want to leave our laces about even length on both sides. Now, I'll go to the inside of the shoe and lace from underneath the first eyelet up through. On the opposite side, I'm going to skip the first eyelet and go to the second. Now, go back to the first side where you started and lace across. So I will go up and over the first eyelet on this side and through from the top down. Okay? I'm now doing the same thing on the other side. Second eyelet, across, through the top, and down. See how the laces are now straight across, ladder up. We'll thread those underneath. And on both sides, we're now coming up through the fourth eyelet. Your laces are now even. We're at the same height with our laces at the fourth eyelet. We'll now return to a traditional crisscross method. This shoe has a spot to help keep the tongue in place. So we'll thread through that from both sides and go back to our X laces. And now we'll lace to the top of the shoe, just like normal. You can still use a runner's loop to help in the back of the foot so that your shoe doesn't slip, but you've created more space in the front through here for someone with a higher instep that feels more volume in the shoe, or a wider midfoot. So now the shoe is not laced so tightly around the edge of your foot. So there's the runner's loop or heel lock, the new way that you should loop, swoop, and pull,
yeah,
and straight lacing.